So let's talk about OLCA. What is OLCA? So based on this article, OLCA is a defined debt completion and evaluation of the input, output, and potential environmental impact of the activity with the organization as above a portion. We will know about the theories, principle, and the framework that will help to design more effective organization. So the participating the organization found that OLCA will manage the amount and other things such as identification of the environmental hotspot, tracking of the environmental performance over time, and the last one is to improving organization decision making.
Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about organizational life cycle assessment of McDonald's. Organizational life cycle assessment can be defined as an analytical tool design which to assess not only the environmental aspect but also in social and economic. It's a very good example in using OLCA to improve sustainability performance. Instead of outlining the carbon footprint at 71%, social and economic responsibilities are also discussed in OLCA of McDonald's. For social dimension, members also protecting the human rights and respectful work in 2020, McDonald's has reached 29% in diversity, but McDonald's are also aiming in 2025 to increase women representation into 45%, including the unrepresented groups such as Asian and Black into 35%. Next, in terms of economics, McDonald's is committed in supporting workers and manufacturers as their preference. For example, McDonald's in Australia has spent $600 million in buying their products.
Hello everyone, today I'm going to share about OLCA of chocolate. Chocolate has long been associated with passion, happiness and love. However, when it comes to taking responsibility for the working and the environmental condition along with the supply chains, the truth behind is saddening. The last thing we want to know about chocolate is that producing chocolate relates to environmental pollution, child labor and low revenue. As a consumer, we can use our buying power in selecting some chocolate brands that practice OLCA. You may choose chocolate brand with certification such as UTZ. With the label, it means that the company is doing internal and external assessment on their impacts. They are likely verified to be environmental friendly, socially responsible, and brings economic benefit along the supply chain, including farmers, traders to manufacture. Thank you for listening.
Are you listening?
If you are born in the 1990s, I'm pretty sure that you have seen a glass bottle of Coca-Cola. Since when did it become a plastic bottle? And why Coca-Cola had to change their packaging? Let's see. In 1970s, Coca-Cola decided to quantify the raw materials and fuels they use and environmental consequences of the entire life cycles of a package from extraction of raw materials and disposal.
This study aims to fill the gaps by integrating social organizational life cycle assessment, that is SOLCA, and Industry 4.0 technologies in a blended methodological approach designed to dynamically monitor the social performance of a major manufacturing industry using primary data, a set of site-specific social indicators and indexes were created to assess the organization's social impact against key stakeholder categories and subcategories.
Good day, now I'm gonna explain about OLCA, which stands for Organization Life Cycle Assessment. First of all, OLCA is one, a quantitative tool to evaluate the impact of a product, a system, or an activity on the environment, economic and social. 2 takes into account a comprehensive set of environmental aspects and potential impacts of a product over its entire life cycle.
There are 3 types of LCA: cradle to grave, cradle to gate, and cradle to cradle. First, cradle to grave. It is a full assessment that includes all the stages of the life cycle, including the resource consumption, emissions, and end-of-life phase, which is likely to involve waste disposal. Second, cradle to gate. It is an evaluation of a portion of the product's life beginning with resource extraction and continuing through the manufacturing gate until being delivered to the consumer. Although other phases are fully aware, just one stage is the subject of the assessment. Third, cradle to cradle. It is very similar to the first type of assessment, but cradle to cradle considers a circular system which the product will not be discarded but will be recycled and utilized back into the cycle. Is OLCA a new tool introduced as recently? No, OLCA has been introduced at least 50 years ago. Little explanation about the history of LCA. The draft concept was first performed by Harold Smith in 1960s by unveiling his cumulative energy concept at the World Energy Conference in 1990s. Kyoto Protocol requires nations to reduce their emission of greenhouse gases LCA of organizations in which transferring the life cycle approach from a product level to a whole company level also uses a life cycle perspective to compile and evaluate the inputs, outputs, and potential impacts of the activities associated within the beyond the gates of the organization's LCA includes four stages: setting a goal and scope, secondly collecting and inventorying necessary data, thirdly conducting impact assessment, which is a stage to collect additional information to understand the significance of the data, lastly interacting the results of the life cycle family. The 3 ISO 14040 series standard, which acts as standards and guidelines. The first standard, ISO 14040 Environmental Management, it was published in 1997 to define the correct process of OLCA. It is like an introduction to the concept in the document. It describes the four phases, principles, and framework of LCA. Second standard, ISO 14044 Environmental Management Life Cycle Assessment Requirements and Guidelines. It was published in 2006 to provide a basic guideline and specify requirements for LCA. For example, the document stated the operator shall communicate the LCA result to the public through third-party reports. The third standard, ISO 14072 Life Cycle Assessment. It is a technical standard published in 2014 to provide additional requirements and guidelines for an effective application of the two standards mentioned in front. It basically provides more detailed guideline it mentioned about the methodology to apply OLCA benefit system boundary, considerations and limitations. Now we come to one of the best examples of the first mover of OLCA, Volkswagen, which commonly known as Volkswagen. The automobile company is committed to reduce the CO2 output of the European new car fleet to emission below the threshold of 120 grams CO2 kilometer by 2015 and furthermore to 95 grams CO2 kilometer by 2020. As early as 1996, the company was the first car maker to prepare and publish a life cycle inventory, LCI, for the Golf 3. Volkswagen defines the serious risk associated with climate change as a central challenge and therefore its environmental focus is on carbon. In the assessment, the company has compared the emissions between diesel car and electric car. In comparison, diesel emits 140 gram carbon dioxide per kilometer on average over its entire life cycle, while the electric car only reaches 119 gram carbon dioxide per kilometer. Volkswagen found most of the emissions occur during the use phase. Diesel reaches 111 gram carbon dioxide per kilometer while electric drive emits only 62 gram carbon dioxide per kilometer, but the carbon emissions of electric car is higher than diesel car due to the battery productions and the complex extractions of raw material. Volkswagen is not calculating the carbon footprint of the used phase only but also the emissions generated by the extractions of raw materials. The productions of components and the assembly are included in the production. Assessment is also done on the use, includes both the emissions of the fuel and electricity supply, and especially those of vehicle operation over 200,000 kilometers. The company also focus on recycling and dismantling as they are trying to have higher potential savings through recycling. From this example, we can see that OLCA is complex. The report stated that the LCA of the tire take hundreds of factors into consideration which involve 14 processes. Volkswagen assures that in first place the carbon dioxide emissions of the supply chain, the entire manufacturing process and logistics have been partially reduced, for example by using green power. Implicitly includes the productions of the high voltage battery. The company is validating the decarbonization approach by confirming that the players in their supply chain, such as manufacture and delivery of the electric cars to the retailer, are independently certified as net carbon neutral.
First challenge is all OLCA modeling relies on the base database. BTAG solution for it is every country needs to have a complete database of at least hundreds of industries, basic energy sources, raw materials, chemicals. Second challenge is traditional LCA software cannot protect intellectual property. As for the solution is users can complete the e-footprint connection and calculation of upstream and downstream data on the cloud server without copying and download, thus establishing a database network. Transparent and reliable at the same time. Protect original data and protect intellectual property rights.